This is lecture number 3 for BIB 1340. This lecture is on the JEDP theory. And this theory is a form of source criticism. That is where they go and they criticize the sources from which the Bible is translated from. So I want to begin with some definitions of the theory and define it and tell you what the theory states. The JEDP theory states that the first five books of the Bible, the Pentateuch, states that they were not written by one author. In other words, they contend that Moses was not the author or the writer of these books. They believe that multiple authors wrote the Pentateuch. This is based on primarily the different names that are used for God in Genesis chapter number 1 and chapter number 2. And so the letters JEDP, they represent different authors that these theorists propose wrote the Pentateuch. The J author or the J source, they believe that every time that the writer uses the term Jehovah or Yahweh, they believe that one author wrote this. Also in the King James Version, this would be translation as Lord, L-O-R-D, all capital letters. And so anytime that the word Lord is used in the Pentateuch, they believe that one author wrote that. Now the E-source, or the Elohist, they believe that every time the term Elohim is used, this would be just translated as God in the King James Version. So, for example, Genesis 1 and 1, in the beginning, God, Elohim, created the heavens and the earth. Anytime the word God is used to define God, they believe that one writer wrote those verses or those chapters. Also, the D source, they believe that a writer or a group of writers wrote the book of Deuteronomy independently of the book of Genesis or the rest of the Pentateuch. And then the P source, they believe that they had a priestly writer that wrote the book of Leviticus. And so the theory begins primarily in the chapters 1 and chapters 2 of Genesis, and then it stretches out from there. It didn't stop with just attributing chapter 1 to one author and chapter 2 to a separate author, but it literally went on to where they would go through all the books of the Old Testament, and they wouldn't just attribute chapters to certain authors, but they would literally take one verse and say that part of this verse was written by one writer and part of this verse was written by a second writer, and they would cut up the different chapters and the different verses in the Old Testament. Now, I do want to look at chapters 1 and 2 of Genesis and sort of explain where this theory originates from. Chapters 1 and 2, we see two different narratives of the creation. The first one is in chronological order. The second one is in categorical order. And chapters 1 and 2 of Genesis does indeed use two different terms to define God. Genesis chapter 1 all the way through Genesis chapter 2 verse number 3, God is called Elohim, just simply God in the King James Version of the Bible. In Genesis chapter 2 verses 4 through 22, God is defined as being Jehovah Elohim, which would be the Lord God. And so we do see that Genesis chapter 1 has one title of God, but Genesis chapter 2 has a different title of God. Now, we have to contend here that Moses never took credit for being the original author of the books, Genesis chapter 1 and chapter 2. It's very possible that two different people did write or did pass down oral tradition on chapters 1 and 2. But we do, however, believe that Moses was the one that compiled those narratives together, and he was the writer, the one who put all of this information together in the Pentateuch. Now let's look at some facts concerning the JEDP theory. The first fact is that this theory is starting to lose credibility among biblical scholars. The theory started with a man by the name of Julius Wellhausen in the 1800s. And Wellhausen took Genesis 1 and 2 and he applied the theory to it, but then he continued on and applied it to the rest of the Pentateuch. He was the one that originally cut up the verses and said that one verse could have multiple authors, that part of the verse was written by somebody, but a second part was written by somebody else. And the successors of Wellhausen, they continued to apply the theory throughout most of the Old Testament, and with particular attention paid to the books of the prophets, to where they said that the prophets were not written by one individual, but they were written by a group of individuals. Now, there's some flaws in this theory that I'd like to point out here for the next few moments. The first flaw I'd like to point out is that Jesus stated that Moses was the writer of the Pentateuch. Another flaw is that none of the sources, the JEPD, none of those sources have ever been found, and there's no references to those sources. Another flaw is that there is so much structure in the Pentateuch, the way it is written, the way it flows from topic to topic and narrative to narrative. It would almost be impossible for one person to come up with a bunch of different sources and merge those together to come up with something so cohesive as the Pentateuch and the way that it is written. And also, another flaw is that even among those that contend and believe the JEPD theory, there is no agreement among those that even support the theory. The theorists have different arguments among themselves about who wrote what and where the break should come and where the sources came from and how the scriptures have been merged together. And so one of the reasons that I believe that the JEPD theory was implemented in the first place was that it is simply just another attack on the validity of the Word of God. It's another attempt to discredit the Bible. And while the theory is losing credibility among some scholars, it is still actively being taught in seminaries across at least the United States. As recent as 1995, one scholar is quoted. He said, and I quote, "The most determined biblicist can see that there is no way Moses could have written the Torah." In 1998, 3 years later, another scholar quoted, "It is obvious that the book of Genesis was not written by a single author." Yet another scholar said that one of the certain results of modern biblical scholar or study has been discovered is that the first five books of the Old Testament were not written by Moses. And so they are literally casting doubt on whether or not Moses was the writer of the Pentateuch. And here is a major flaw. Here is a major problem with what these scholars have concluded with. Number one, the Pentateuch itself states that Moses is the writer. Exodus 24:4 says, "And Moses wrote all the words of the Lord." Exodus 34:27 says, "And the Lord said unto Moses, write thou these words." Numbers 33:2, "And Moses wrote their going out and according to their journeys by the commandment of the Lord." One more here, Deuteronomy 31:9, "And Moses wrote this law and delivered it unto the priest." So you have the Pentateuch itself stating that Moses is the writer of these scriptures. And as already been said in this lecture, Jesus in the New Testament also stated that Moses was the writer of the law. Mark 12:26, "Have you not read in the book of Moses?" Mark 10:3, "And he answered and said unto them, what did Moses command you?" Luke 24:44, "Which were written in the law of Moses." Again, this is all Jesus speaking here. John 7:19, "Did not Moses give you the law?" And so here you have scholars on one hand saying that there is no way Moses wrote the books, but yet on the other hand, Jesus is saying that Moses did indeed write these books. And so what does all this mean? Why would they come up with a theory like this? And the reason they would come up with a theory like this is they would like to discredit the authorship of the books of the Pentateuch. And here is the crux of the matter. If they can cast doubt on whether or not Moses was the author of the Pentateuch or whether he was the writer of the Pentateuch, then literally they can go over to the New Testament and they can say, well, now you have Jesus saying this, but yet what Jesus is saying is not true. In essence, they are trying to discredit the very words of Jesus. And so if they can prove that Jesus didn't know what he was talking about when it comes to the authorship of Moses, then they can begin to discredit other things that Jesus said. And so now there's this perpetual cycle that happens to where they literally discredit all the words of Jesus. And so the underlying theme here, as if they can cast doubt in one area of scripture, then they can literally discredit the entirety of the Word of God. They can cast light on the entire validity of all the scriptures. So in conclusion here, this is the JEPD theory But my conclusion to all of this is that I believe and I contend that Moses was the writer of the Pentateuch. I also stand firmly with the Old Testament and with the words of Jesus declaring that he was the author of these books. I don't know how it all happened. I don't know how he put all this together. I don't have the answers of how the Pentateuch was compiled, but I do know the Bible does give us an insight here in 2 Peter 1 and 21. It says that prophecy came not in the old time by the will of man, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. And I believe that's how it happened. I believe that through the power of the Holy Ghost and through the anointing of the Holy Ghost, Moses was anointed to write down the books of the Pentateuch. And he was, while not the author of it, as while God is the author, but Moses was the writer of these books. And this is what the Bible teaches, this is what the Bible says, and this is what I believe.